Oh, that little thing? Oh, that's the Eiffel Tower, but I've been here 3 times, so it doesn't really please me anymore. Yeah, I guess for some people, it's a landmark, the Eiffel Tower.
Despite being a divisive city, I love Paris. The terraces fill with people catching up with old friends. The windows of these Parisian apartments lure you to look into them. Its vibrancy, permeating its streets, its park, its people. My mom and brother visited me in Paris wishing they could feel that same love. And with luck, you can feel it too. Here's another vlog in Paris.
Currently drinking my matcha latte that I got at this cafe. That was about like 10 minutes away with transit from here. Anyways, like, guys, do you see this? This is such a vibe.
Indeed, Paris is a vibe. As my TikTok seemed to be inundated with Paris hate, I unfortunately, do not subscribe to that mentality. I love Paris. I am utterly enamored with her intoxicating energy. Every single time I come back, I am reminded more and more about why I love it. With each revisit of the French capital, a smile permanently stays on my face until I have to leave again. I encourage my brother to come and see me in this divisive city that has completely won me over. And my mom wanted to visit me during my Euro trip. As I tried to balance their distinct traveling style and travel bucket list, I decided to forego my own to follow their wants. I extended my stay another 2 days to do everything that I wish, and this vlog is about those 2 days. Let's fast forward 5 days to that moment.
I know that everyone and their mother, and their mother's mistress, their father, father's mistress, their brother's girlfriend, who's also making out with both mistresses. Plot twist, everyone's hooking up with each other. Their drug dealer, their maid, who is also, plot twist, making out with your mother. There's a lot of adultery happening in that family. I'm kind of losing track of my story. Everyone is in Paris. I did not get the memo that everyone was going to Paris, but every single time I open TikTok, every single time I open YouTube, one of my favorite influencers seemed to be going to Paris, and I'm like, oh my God, another one? Why is everyone moving or visiting Paris right now? Everyone is having a Paris moment, which is great. I shouldn't be complaining. Like, literally, where am I? Where am I currently? Oh yeah, I'm fucking Paris, okay? I'm also in Paris with everyone else. So I really shouldn't be like dismissive, because I'm not gonna lie, okay? I fucking love Paris, okay? I've always did. I think it's such a beautiful city, and I'm gonna let a voiceover Kim Ann describe it way better than I can, because I am not, as we previously established, I am not good at complimenting things on the spot. So, voiceover command, take it away.
Well, sorry to disappoint, babe, but I'm not going to be complimenting Paris just now. I'm going to instead tell you guys about my
humongous, thick ass, chunky ass
list of things to do in Paris. First, go to my walk on Boulevard Verte René Dumont, which is the park that I'm currently on. I also really want to go to Pilon, Shakespeare and Company, and pick up a book that I already ordered. Place Vosges, Place Vendôme, a fancy ass bug neighborhood. Val de Grâce, a neighborhood that harbors the Panthéon. Rue de Crémieux, a quaint, colorful street. Petit Palais, which has a free, peaceful, hidden garden. Canavale Museum, which harbors a gorgeous free garden. Vianney, the most breathtaking public library. And Line 6, the metro line with the most picturesque view of the Eiffel Tower. Jesus, am I trying to give myself a heart attack? But heart attack be gone, for I'm taking a peaceful walk on the Promenade Plantée or Coulée Verte René Dumont. Coulée Verte is an elevated park with flowers and plants all over, all in proximity to residential complexes that surround it. Sounds familiar? If you are thinking of the High Line in New York, you're correct, for it inspired the iconic New York landmark. The park was also the setting to one of my favorite segments of the movie Before Sunset.
It was our last day.
Yeah, what would we talk about? What would you tell me, for example?
Well,
that's hard.
No, well, no, I'll do it. I definitely.
definitely. A place where there's actual lighting, okay, where you can actually see my face. A beautiful and gorgeous face. But here it is, drinking a beautiful matcha latte.
Every day I go to two cafes, and even though I only went to one on that day, I actually went to the same cafe twice because it was that great. The cafe in question, the coffee. Simple, to the point. The cafe is modern, sleek, and minimal. The drinks themselves are absolutely exquisite. And as an iced coffee enthusiast, this cafe was absolutely perfect. Now I feel like giving you guys a little rundown of every cafe and restaurant that I visited with my family, just so you know where to go and where to maybe skip. Also, I usually go to third wave cafes instead of the usual French cafes because they're the only place you can order an iced latte without being judged. I love iced lattes too much and don't have a judgment king, so I'll instead stick with my non-traditional French cafes. First, a beloved cafe called Buddy Buddy, a nut bird cafe. The place has that same sleek vibe as the coffee, but the drinks are questionable. Personally, it's not my taste, not the biggest fan of peanut butter in my latte. I wouldn't mind going back, but I would not go out of my way to revisit. Second, W Square Cube Cafe. Mostly known for having these sweet Taiwanese cube sandwiches, which was absolutely delicious, babes. I went back twice. The service is a little cold, as expected from Paris, but the sandwiches were to die for. Recommend, definitely. Third, another Paris staple, Boulangerie Aki, which has now fully integrated into my Paris routine. As a matcha bean, this place is heaven. It is basically a Japanese-French cafe that truly paws my pussy every time I come back. A must. Fourth, another Paris institution, Café Kitsune. Their iced drink selection is mouth-watering. You wanna die? Kill yourself. And then drink any drink from their menu and resuscitate because you have a reason to live. Fifth, Kadowari Ramen Chu Kiji. The place is supposed to be reminiscent of Japanese fish markets, and they really went all out with the vibe, so much so that the background music is the noise of the docks. The ramen itself is decent, but I would not wait in that stupidly long line to eat that again. And now, back to the vlog.
Track. Currently at Place Vosges. Musical La Vallée is unfortunately closed for today. And Petit Palais aussi. Oh my god, Petit Palais was so gorgeous. Like, literally, I saw pictures of it. And there's like this garden that's hidden. Entry is completely free, so it would have been so nice to be able to go there. But unfortunately, I can't. Benef. Oh my fucking god. Damn it. I really did a good job planning my last day. So we basically went from a list of like 10 to 5 now. Which is great, actually, because it means that I'm not gonna have to stress out about not being able to do everything that I wanted to do. But guys, I think this is a sign that I should move to Paris. I have this book right here. Okay, first of all, the writing is sublime.
Lie to Me by Philippe Besson, or Arrête avec les mensonges. It's basically him describing his first love. It's from the perspective of him as an elderly person, thinking back on what it was like to be 17-year-old and putting that in perspective with how the rest of his life is going to pan out, which is just absolutely fascinating to see it go back and forth between the past, which is him as a 17-year-old experiencing his first love as a gay man in the middle of France, and him as a successful writer 20, 30 years before. It's just like so immersive when it comes to all of the emotions, which is so surprising considering how small this book is. Seriously, if you ever have the chance to read this book, I suggest it because it's absolutely beautiful.
There are so many people that read books like literally everywhere. I feel like I've never seen that many people read books as much as I do in this city. So just seeing all the people reading books has really inspired me. The only problem is that it's a movie poster cover. When the bookstore employee gave me the book and I saw that movie poster cover, I was like, oh, pardon me dying, because this is not Parisian vibe, okay? First of all, I thought French people were snobs. I thought French people were elitist. Having a movie poster cover is not elitist or snobbish enough. Like, I need them to snobbish it up because this is just not a vibe, okay? I can't be seen in the streets of Paris, in the metro Paris, reading this book, okay? People are going to think I'm mental. So I was like, you know what? Maybe I should buy White Album by Joe Didion to read on the streets of Paris. But the problem is that it's an English book. Reading an English book in the streets of Paris is not very Parisian. So, Guys, I have not gone to a cafe and smoked a cigarette while reading.
Give me that my first language is French, the only language to my knowledge that cherishes the act of strolling aimlessly under the word of Flâne. Unlike the majority of North America, where walking can be dismissed as the poor man's mobility in favor of the car, in France, the act of Flâne carries bourgeois connotation, while mostly 19th century literature. A man rich and comfortable enough to freely walk around, not constrained by space nor time. By Flâne, he learns the city's ways and secrets. By Flâne, he becomes a modern man of cosmopolitan taste. Many travel for food, for experiences, for fashion, for hiking. I travel to walk. Also, it helps that it doesn't require any money. And what better city for me to stroll around aimlessly than the city that invented the word to romanticize my favorite pastime? I walked Paris' street as the sun was about to set, the Lattesian limestone hugging every last rays of sun, splashing it on all its buildings. I walked past the Seine feeling joy by osmosis as friends catch up, couples cuddle up, as people enjoy their solitude admiring the horizon, the grandiose buildings framing the river that runs through the heart of Paris. I walked around Val de Grâce, losing myself in the city's maze, coming across small streets lined with restaurants waiting to be discovered, French people endlessly talking and continuously smoking. I walked past its numerous terraces, people watching as people watch me. I walked through this neighborhood as a warm yellow hue laid over the city, celebrating the arrival of night where Paris still brightens as a city of lights.
French girly pops, let's slay. Literally, we're about to decapitate the heads of the monarch or anyone that supports the system. I was supposed to leave at around 10:30. I don't feel like it, guys. I want to spend more time in Paris. So I'm going to spend an inordinate amount of money on a train later today. Because guys, I just really want to stay here. I just really want to stay here for a little bit longer. Guys, since I am actually leaving on a later time than expected, I could actually go to the Musée Carnavalet and to the Petit Palais. Yes! Okay guys, I'm so happy, okay? Oh my god! giving the gift of time. Paris is just such a beautiful city, and I have to stay here for a little bit longer. I just have to. Currently right now, I'm in the museum of Musée Carnavalet, which is actually, oh my God, it's such an interesting museum because it's about the history of Paris. I unfortunately do not have the time to browse around this museum, even though I would love to, because the history of cities just absolutely fascinates me. I love learning about the architecture and initial design of cities and how it progressed through time. Cross this from the list. Let go. Musée Carnavalet. So now I have the Petit Palais, BNF, and Place Vendôme. Maybe we'll see. I feel so relaxed. I feel so chill. I just feel so at peace. I'm just so happy to be able to be given like the gift of time. Just relax, chill in Paris, walk around and not be stressed. This terrace is fucking gorgeous. It's a play, it's a serve. It's fucking a pussy popper. Seriously, it's so beautiful. There's so many chairs that you can just like sit on to like read a book, chill, vibe for free. And not to mention, if you want to go to the museum, you also have a free museum to add on to that. So frankly, if you ever come to Paris, you should come here. Like, why wouldn't you come here for free stuff? We love free shit. Shot of me reading a book in the library has not been secured because I need to see Timothée Chalamet before I leave, okay? Timothée Chalamet, wait for me! We're here at Timothée Chalamet! Guys, fuck opera, okay? Fuck opera. Why care about opera when you can care about Timothée Chalamet? Thank you, Chanel. Thank you for reminding us about the important things in life, okay? No one gives a shit about opera, but everyone does give a shit about Timothée Chalamet. Thank you, Timothée Chalamet, for blessing us all with your face. Enough with Timothée Chalamet, and unfortunately of Paris too, as I unfortunately had to leave the city of lights, love, fashion to go to my next destination. It is with a heavy heart that I have to bid adieu to Paris. Goodbye to these Haussmannian buildings, these neoclassical apartments that make this city look like a dream. Goodbye to the crowds of people, the families, the couples, the groups of friends, so many of them, too self-involved to care, an almost freeing attribute that gives anyone the space to be whoever they want and do whatever they want. Goodbye to this vast city, small squares and parks hidden in the nook and cranny of the capital, a labyrinth you lose yourself for hours by strolling aimlessly, or as PBC established, by Flâne. Goodbye to these countless Asian-themed cafes that offer an exquisite ice drink selection, salivating still thinking about it. Goodbye to its omnipresent art, permeating its buildings, its gardens, street corners, sometimes in unexpected ways. Goodbye to this book lover's dream, the bookstores, the countless of people that read in cafes and gardens in the metro, so much so that it kind of encourages you to do the same. Goodbye to these monumental buildings reminds you of all the history that unfolded in this city. These landmarks sitting next to small alleyways, streets, parks, where you can forget momentarily that you're one of the biggest cities in the world. Goodbye to her boulevards, gardens, buildings, such grandiosity that makes you feel invincible. Goodbye to this divisive city that disappoints many, that angers others, but charmed me. A plus, Paris.